Hey everyone, and once again welcome to WsCube Tech English channel. Myself Umar Taskeer. Guys, in this particular video we are basically going to talk about how can we actually name our campaigns, ad sets, and this is what we are basically going to discuss in this particular video. Guys, this particular video has nothing to do with the campaign optimization or very technical implementation of the Facebook ad. When we give names to our campaigns, ad sets or ads, it is basically for the advertisers only, because it makes this complete campaign structure very convenient to understand, right? So how can we name our campaign? Because whenever we are going to create a new campaign, the very first thing that we will be asked is basically to put the name of your campaign, and we will be asked to put the name of our ad set and then our ad respectively, right? So how can we name them? And this is what we are going to discuss. So as soon as you will click on this create campaign option, and as soon as you will select any one of your campaign objective, you will be asked over here to create the name of this campaign or to give a name of this campaign. So how can we name our campaigns? We have different like formats or templates that we can actually use, and this is very relative. It is not like constant thing. It is very dynamic. It changes with respect to what you actually want, or with respect to what basically suits you, right? So it is basically quite user oriented. It has nothing to do with the standard or the formatting. There is nothing standard formatting to name any campaign. It is up to you how you actually name it, because it is for your convenience. Whenever you see so much of campaigns within your account, you should be able to identify that what is this campaign all about, or why we are running this particular campaign, or what does campaign actually mean, or ad set or ad, what does it actually mean, right? So this is why we have the names of the campaign, ad set and ad. So as you can see over here on my laptop screen, I have some formats for the campaign that you can actually use. You can use your product service, you can use your campaign objective, and I will recommend you to use your campaign objective in each and every campaign name. That will be very much convenient for you. Along with your product service and objective, you can use a number over here, you can use the date of creation. You can use the date of creation along with the creator of the campaign. You can also use the type of the ad that you are using or that you are serving within that particular campaign. So now let me name it, right? So what we can do is, suppose we are selling t-shirts, right? We are selling t-shirts. A t-shirt is a product, right? So this is again an example. T-shirt is a product for us. So we are selling t-shirts, and the objective of this campaign is traffic. And then this campaign is campaign number one. So this is again a very basic structure that we have over here. And let's take an example of the service. So suppose we are providing digital marketing consultancy, and for that we are actually running this campaign. So we are running campaign for digital marketing consultancy, and we can put small hyphen over here, and we can see if the objective of this campaign is lead generation. We can do the lead generation. We can simply write lead generation over here. And then what we can do is, we can write date of creation over here, like 21st 01 2021. Now we can write the date of creation of this campaign. Now we can shuffle these things also, like we can write lead generation over here, which is basically the objective, and lead generation for digital marketing consultancy, and then the date of creation of this campaign, which is like this one, right? So we can shuffle all these elements also. This is totally up to us. That is what I was telling you, there's no set rule. But yes, if we follow some template which suits us, it will become very easy for us to use them, because if we follow any template, we will become habitual to that thing, right? So this is how we can actually name our campaign. Then we have other template also, like product, service, objective, date of creation and name of the creator. This thing we can also do, like we can write this thing, okay? And then we can put the name over here also. We can write the initials of this thing, like DMC. For the lead generation, we can simply write LG. Now it is up to us that how we relate to this thing, but we can definitely use these kind of initials to understand that it is for the lead generation, it is for the digital marketing consultancy. Similarly, if we are providing any other service also, like we are providing for a digital marketing course, we can write digital marketing course. If it is lead generation, and if we want to enter any date over here, that too we can also do, right? And then the name of the creator, like Ram, right? So this is how we can do this thing. Then another template we have over here for the campaign, that can be like product, service, objective and the type of ad. That is again we can do, right? So we can write product, like iPhone covers. If we are selling iPhone covers, we can write iPhone covers over here. If the campaign objective is conversion, we can simply write conversion over here. And then we can write the type of the ad. So if we are running any specific carousel ads over here, we can write this campaign is for the carousel ads. And if we have any other ads, like if we have video ads, we can write video ads over here. So this is again a way of giving names to our campaign. Now we can do this thing practically also. As soon as you will come over here on this campaign section over here, what you can do is you can name your campaign, and let's select one example over here. So if we follow this thing where we are basically doing this thing, right? So let's copy and let's paste it over here. Now we will click on continue, right? As soon as we will click on continue and we close this thing, now you can see we have campaign name over here that we can again edit. Either we can put a name like this one, or what we can do is we can create a name from the existing info. Like we can select campaign name over here, whatever the campaign name is, that will come in the beginning, and then the campaign objective will come over here, right? We can change the separators from here also. So we can either select a comma, or we can either go with this hyphen, or we can change this to like this slash over here, forwarding slash. So we have all these options over here. And now what we can do is we can go ahead and write some custom text also over here. Like if we require any custom text, we can also write that thing. So we can write the custom text also if it is actually required, right? So we have a template kind of thing also over here. Then coming back to our this thing, these examples, we have ad set related naming examples. So I have some examples over here. Suppose we want to create three ad sets, and these three ad sets are for like different audience. Then how can we actually create this? Like 18 to 35, right? This one is the audience, and people are from Delhi, and they are like men, and that their interest is cooking. We can either name it like 18 to 24. And the people are from India, and the audience set is cart audience, people who visited our cart page. This audience can be people who visited our cart page, right? So we have again this option over here, or we can use these kind of ad sets name. Another examples are also here. As you can see, ad set number one is from 18 to 35, this age group. And if we have one variable, which is variable over here is city. So we have this particular variable like city, and all the other things are same. And if all these three ad sets are within a single campaign, right? If all these ad sets are within a single campaign, then what we can do is we can basically name all these ad sets like this one, like ad set 1, 2, and 3. In the form of numbers, we can write the same age, we can write the same gender, and along with this only the location option which is there, or the location targeting which is there, it will only change. Rest other things will remain same, right? So this is how we can actually name our ad sets. Then we have another another example over here, which is again for the same campaign. If we are creating different ad sets within a same campaign, how can we basically name them so that they look decent also, and it is like user friendly also, or advertiser friendly also. So you can see ad set 1, 2, 3 will give us an idea that how many ad sets we have within our campaign, and the numbers will also indicate us something. Now we have 18 to 35 age group. 18 to 35 age group is basically what we are targeting in this particular ad set. Then we have same location, we have same gender, but here we are targeting cold audience based on demographics, based on behavior, and based on interest. So if we are we are creating different ad sets for the purpose of creating different audience or different target audience, we can do it this way. And guys, then we also have the option of giving names to ads, right? So as we come over here and as we cancel this thing, as we come over here at the ad set level or any ad level, we have this option over here. We can also create our ad set name by the existing info which is given over here, or we can also create the name of the ad, or we can basically do it manually, or if we want to put some templates, we can also do that, right? So guys, these are the different options that we have. So if we come to ad set, what we can do is basically we can give it a name like this one, right? So let me copy this thing over here, and let me paste it over here. Now guys, advertiser can easily understand that what they are actually targeting within this ad set. So as I told you in the very beginning, that it has nothing to do with the campaign optimization, it has nothing to do with the campaign algorithm or the Facebook's algorithm or kind of scaling of ads or like that, right? But it is very important when you are running multiple campaigns, or when you want that your ad account should look structured, properly structured, and it should, I mean each and everything which is there, each and every name which is there, it should reflect something, it should provide some meaning, it should not be very vague, right? So if you will give proper names to your ads, to your ad sets, or to your like campaigns, it will definitely provide some meaning and it will not look very vague, right? So coming back over here on our this notepad, we can also name our ads. So as you can see, how we are actually naming our ad, what we have to do is we have to write the type of the ad and then the number, right? So if we are running carousel ad, we can write carousel ads, and then if there is anything which is identifiable in that carousel ads, you can also write that thing, like blue color carousels, and this is ad number one for you, okay? And if we have other carousels also, like these carousels are pink, you can name it like pink, and then this is the ad number two. So this is useful when you have multiple ads, which you will have obviously if you want to test something. So you can name it like video ads, and if it is for 30 seconds, you can write 30 seconds video ad, and this is number one. And if you have another video ad which is for like 15 seconds, you can name it like 15 seconds, and this is ad number two, right? So this is how you actually name your ad. And as I told you, the basic is that every naming, whether it is on your campaign or on your ad set or on your ad, it should reflect something, it should provide some meaning, it should not be like meaningless, right? So that's it. I believe you got to know the importance of naming the camp and what are the different templates that we can actually use. And these are not, I mean, these templates are not like 100% perfect. You can create your own templates. These templates also depends on the nature of the business that you do or the type of the campaigns that you do run, right? So it has no actual formula, and it depends from individual to individual how they actually want to name their campaigns. So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.